About a week after Bill had returned from the steamworks, the tank engine twins were getting ready for the day's work at the container yard. As the firelighter got their fires going, an unfamiliar diesel horn sounded out. Both twins looked over to see a Class 14 diesel approaching. She stopped just short of the shed, and the Fat Controller climbed down from her cab.
Bill and Ben, allow me to introduce Iris. She'll be taking over here when you leave on Friday.
The twins exchanged an excited look.
You mean we're going back to the quarry?
Yes. The safety inspectors have completed their investigation of the tunnel collapse.
What did they find?
The Fat Controller glanced at her smartphone.
Apparently, the collapse was caused by an undiagnosed fracture in the steel tunnel support.
Well, manager did say they were cheaper. And driver says you get what you pay for.
Anyway, we'd better get on with today's work. Miss Hack told me you'd show me how to do things around here.
I've got to get Patrick's fast goods to barrel ready. That's over in the container section. You're welcome to help with that.
Very well,
Iris said curtly. As she and Bill departed, Ben watched them go.
She's not one for small talk, is she?
Iris worked in a munitions factory before I bought her.
Iris helped Bill put together the first two container trains. She wasn't shy about putting in effort where it was needed.
Iris, could you bring those trucks from the arrival track in here? Bear's gonna need that clear in a few minutes.
Ben asked, once the container trains were ready.
Those ones? Certainly.
Iris buffered up to the trucks, which Percy had delivered earlier. Her driver had only just coupled her up when another diesel's horn drifted through the air. Glancing back, Iris saw Bear approaching with his trucks.
Driver, quickly!
Bear blew his horn again and stopped short of the points, just inside the yard limits.
No need to rush on my account,
said the high mech, as Iris hurried to move her trucks out of the way.
That was a few minutes, was it?
It's not my fault if Bear arrived early.
Iris didn't say any more. At least, not until after Bear had left.
You should have anticipated Bear's arrival.
How? We have a schedule for arrivals and departures. That's generally when trains arrive and depart, you know.
That is precisely my point. Getting things ready 5 minutes earlier would avoid delays like that one just now.
What delay? Bear departed right on time.
It's the principle.
Iris departed abruptly to collect more trucks. Neither of the twins spoke until she was out of earshot.
Is it just me, Bill? Or does old Fusspot over there make Sheffield seem polite? Huh, you're right there.
Bill paused for a moment, and a mischievous glint came into his eye.
Maybe she just needs to have a bit of a laugh. What have you got in mind?
Bill whispered something to Ben, and both engines giggled.
Peter's got a train due out in about half an hour. We'll do it then.
About 20 minutes later, Iris was getting Peter's train ready when Bill came alongside.
Iris, what are you doing?
Getting Peter's train ready. He is going to be picking it up in 10 minutes.
I meant with that delicate load.
What delicate load?
Didn't the terminal manager tell you? That second flat car back has a delicate load in one of its containers. We usually shunt them right at the front so they're directly coupled to the locomotive. It's to prevent slack action.
Makes sense.
Iris knew she'd have just enough time to rearrange the flat cars. As she moved off to do so, she didn't notice Bill grinning mischievously. Peter arrived just as Iris was finishing her shunting. As the Stanier 8F backed down onto the train, the terminal manager came up to Iris.
Iris, why did you take so long to arrange that train?
My apologies, sir, but I wasn't aware of the delicate load on the first flat car. I believe we are supposed to shunt those at the head of the train?
That's correct, but there aren't any delicate loads on that train.
Iris frowned.
What? But Bill told me...
She broke off as Bill chuffed up alongside.
Sorry, Iris. I guess it must have been thinking of another flat car.
That is rather irresponsible, Bill. If you're going to be working in my yard,
So this is your yard now.
I thought Miss Hat made that perfectly clear.
Bill just chuckled and steamed off. Peter looked over from the next track.
They got me with that one too, a few weeks ago.
You mean that was a prank?
Oh yes, of course. From what I've heard, those two have a history of them.
Peter paused for a moment, thinking of the stories he'd heard over the years.
Just ask Gordon what happened when he went down the Brendan Branch by mistake, or Boca about the first time he met them. They're harmless, though.
Oh, I know that. But there is a time and place for pranks. It's not when you're on duty in my yard.
You can try telling them that.
That won't work. I've met jokers like them before.
Well, it's only for another few days. They're leaving on Friday.
Peter pointed out. He'd grown quite fond of the twins over the last few months.
I suppose you've got a point.
For the rest of the day, Bill, Ben and Iris worked without incident. Several times, Iris told Bill and Ben how they could be doing things better, although it was mostly minor stuff. They didn't give her any more trouble, but Iris was warily watching out for any further tricks. To be honest, she found it rather distracting. Later that afternoon, Iris was taking some empty trucks from the container terminal back to the main yard. She looked around curiously as she approached, taking in the arrangement of the tracks and how the trucks were sorted. Then, her gaze fell upon the engine working the yard.
You must be Iris. I'm Diesel.
I can see that. But what's your name?
That is my name.
Iris was about to say more, when a half-forgotten memory came back to her.
Not the same Diesel who got kicked off this island back in 1957 or so.
That's the only other engine I've heard of by that name.
Diesel's face fell.
So you've heard that story then?
You could call it that. I don't know how many engines told and retold it before it got to me. What I heard was that you played some pranks that weren't so harmless.
That's one way of putting it. Diesel sighed. That was a mistake on my part, over 50 years ago. I've been trying very hard to leave it behind.
I see.
Iris paused as another thought struck her. She'd been slightly distracted, looking out for more of Bill and Ben's tricks. But maybe there was a way to ensure they wouldn't play any more on her.
May I ask, what's your stance on harmless pranks?
What do you mean?
Iris outlined what she had in mind. By the time she'd finished, Diesel was smiling slyly.
I see your point, Iris, and that would be fun. Leave it to me.
With that, he sidled off. Around morning tea time the next day, Henry arrived at the container terminal with the train of trucks, which were to be transloaded at the warehouse. After leaving his trucks on the arrival track, Henry glanced over towards Bill, who was shunting some container flats.
Oi, Bill, you know where my container flat is?
Your what?
My container flat. I'm supposed to be taking a container flat down to Kildane on my next train.
Usually, engines heading out via the main yard picked up their loaded container flats before collecting other trucks.
I'll just have to check, Henry. Hey, Ben! What is it, Bill? Ben, did you shunt a container flat for Henry? No, I thought you were supposed to be getting those ready. Well, Iris kind of done it. She's been on the other side of the yard all morning. What was supposed to be on this flat car, Henry?
A tank container with a shipment of sodium-infused dihydrogen monoxide for that pickling plant at Peel Godred, and a container of machine parts for the aluminium plant.
Both twins exchanged a worried look. They didn't quite know what that first item was, but both shipments had sounded important.
We'll get it for you, Henry.
But before Bill or Ben could move, Iris came up alongside.
What's going on? Henry, you should have left by now.
Oh, there seems to be some sort of mix-up with the flat car. Diesel said I'd need to pick it up this morning.
Henry said, with a meaningful wink at Iris.
I see,
Iris said, as the penny dropped. She glanced over at Bill and Ben.
It's just as well for you two that Henry's flat car doesn't actually exist.
Well, that would explain Hold on, what?
It's just a prank, Bill. I believe you're familiar with those.
Bill and Ben stared at each other for a moment, then burst out laughing.
We are, yes. You certainly got us there, Henry.
Oh, it wasn't my idea,
replied the green engine, shooting a significant glance at Iris. The twins stared at her, shocked.
You?
Well, you did trick me with that delicate load business yesterday.
You've made your point, Iris. We won't try to trick you again.
Good,
Iris replied, satisfied.
Say, what's that sodium-infused dihydro... what's it?
Sodium-infused dihydrogen monoxide. It's a fancy term for salt water, I believe.
Henry knew that the pickling plant used a lot of it, although they called it brine solution.
Thank you, Henry.
Glad to be of service.
With that, Henry chuffed off. He was looking forward to telling Gordon about that morning's events. For the rest of that day, the China Clay twins worked with Iris. They kept their word and didn't play any tricks at all. The next morning, it was time for them to return to the China Clay Quarry.
Well, I guess we'll be seeing you around, Iris. Yes, do come and visit us in the China Clay Quarry sometime.
If I had a chance.
The twins departed a moment later, and Iris watched them go. For all their childishness, she thought, they were good engines. A whistle sounded out, and Iris glanced over to see Percy arriving with the train from Tory Wreck. She moved off to shunt the little engine's train. This was her yard, now, and it was time for her to get to work.